Welcome to another exciting update on the British royal family, where we delve into the latest happenings with Princess Catherine, King Charles, and the recent royal controversies. Today, let's chat about the resilience and grace of a future queen, exemplified by none other than Catherine, the Princess of Wales. Recently, the royal family found itself at the center of a heated discussion following the release of a controversial book. Amidst this, Princess Catherine has emerged as a figure of strength and poise. It's intriguing to ponder what it takes to be a queen. It's not just about perfecting the royal wave, though a strong wrist certainly helps. A queen must navigate the complexities of royal life, often having to steer clear of the dramas stirred up by other family members. Historically, English monarchs, including queens, have shown remarkable fortitude. They've managed kingdoms while their husbands ventured off on ambitious, sometimes quixotic conquests. This tradition of strong queenship seems to be alive and well in Princess Catherine. Just this Tuesday, she attended a diplomatic reception at Buckingham Palace with King Charles, marking their first joint appearance since the recent uproar. While opinions about her outfit that evening may vary, Catherine's elegance is undeniable. But beyond appearances, it's her inner strength that's been most on display. Rumors and accusations have swirled around the royal family, especially concerning comments about Prince Archie before his birth. The truth of these matters likely remains within the royal inner circle. Yet, through it all, Catherine has navigated these turbulent waters with remarkable composure. Her conduct in recent events has only solidified her image as a resilient and capable figure, ready to assume the role of queen when the time comes. As we continue to watch the royal family's story unfold, Princess Catherine's ability to maintain grace under pressure remains a noteworthy aspect of her public persona. In the ever-evolving narrative of the British royal family, Princess Catherine continues to demonstrate her potential as a future queen, a role shaped by centuries of formidable women. Let's rewind to the end of November, when the book Endgame hit the shelves. The book cast a rather unflattering light on Catherine, labeling her as indolent and submissive, particularly in contrast to Meghan Markle's assertive presence. The portrayal went as far as to depict her as unwelcoming to Meghan, allegedly withholding both advice and a soothing glass of Whispering Angel. However, these claims, as contentious as they are, didn't quite hit the mark of a definitive scandal. But this was just the tip of the iceberg. Soon after, a startling disclosure emerged from the Dutch edition of Endgame. It inadvertently named King Charles and Princess Catherine as the alleged royal family members who had concerns about the complexion of Prince Archie, Meghan, and Harry's son. This allegation, which Harry later refuted, stirred up a media storm. The reaction was mixed. While the British press largely supported Catherine, opinions on social media were sharply divided. Buckingham Palace, true to form, remained silent on the issue. Through this whirlwind of controversy, Catherine, the 10th Princess of Wales, has shown commendable resilience, bolstering her image as a future queen capable of handling royal crises with grace. Amidst this turmoil, Catherine's royal duties continued. She and Prince William, the Prince of Wales, hosted Crown Princess Victoria of Sweden and her husband, Prince Daniel, in a showcase of royal solidarity across Europe. Their day of engagements culminated in an elegant evening at the Royal Albert Hall, further highlighting the poise and composure of Catherine under the spotlight of public scrutiny. Let's dive into the latest updates from the royal family, where Princess Catherine continues to shine amidst recent controversies. Her style evolution was notably on display at the annual Royal Variety performance. Catherine dazzled in a custom Sophia gown, complete with strikingly dramatic sleeves, showcasing her impeccable fashion sense. Even when faced with unexpected questions about the racism allegations as she entered the hall, Catherine remained the epitome of calm and grace. It was as if the swirling rumors and accusations hadn't touched her at all. Catherine's recent visit to a children's day surgery unit at a London hospital further highlighted her unflappable demeanor. She radiated tranquility, appearing as refreshed and composed as if she just returned from a relaxing holiday. This calmness was all the more remarkable given the potential PR crisis surrounding her. That same day, she attended the diplomatic reception, an event where she typically looks every bit the princess, dressed in glamorous attire. But what's truly remarkable is the public's reaction to Catherine throughout this entire episode. Far from facing backlash, there seems to be no noticeable decline in support for her. In fact, it appears the opposite is true. Some are even humorously suggesting that her adept handling of the situation could warrant sainthood. Catherine's dignified silence in the midst of this whole Endgame saga has only endeared her further to her supporters. It seems that the book has merely reinforced existing opinions about her. Those who previously viewed Catherine negatively might see the book's claims as confirmation of their beliefs. Conversely, those who have always seen Meghan and Harry as overly critical might view Catherine's behavior as further proof of her strength and character. This whole situation has only deepened the divide in public opinion, with each camp interpreting events to fit their pre-existing views of the royal family. Let's continue our discussion about the British royal family, focusing on Princess Catherine's role as the Princess of Wales and her journey towards queenship. It's clear that recent events have only bolstered the admiration many hold for her, myself included. Catherine's resilience in the face of personal attacks and controversies is nothing short of remarkable. What's particularly impressive is her embodiment of a distinctly British ethos, the power of maintaining silence and stoicism in the face of adversity. This approach is often seen as a virtue in British culture, where public displays of emotion or reaction are typically downplayed. Catherine's ability to adhere to this philosophy is admirable and seems almost valorous. Contrasting sharply with this silence was her reported active involvement in the royal family's response to Meghan and Harry's interview with Oprah. According to Valentine Lowe, it was Catherine who advocated for the inclusion of the memorable phrase, "Recollections may vary." Interestingly, despite the global attention garnered by the recent book release, its sales figures tell a different story. Valentine Lowe, through a platform formerly known as Twitter, shared that Endgame hasn't been flying off the shelves. In the UK, it was narrowly outsold by Lowe's own book in its first week, and in the US, it hasn't broken into Amazon's top 100 bestsellers. While I can't provide any insights into the prophesied rapture, I can say that Catherine's journey to becoming queen is progressing steadily. It's a journey marked by dignity, strength, and a remarkable ability to rise above controversy. What are your thoughts on this situation? Feel free to share your opinions and engage in this conversation. Wrapping up our latest insights on Princess Catherine and the unfolding royal family saga, it's been a journey of observing grace under pressure. As we continue to follow these developments, Catherine's path towards queenship remains a topic of significant interest and admiration. Thank you for joining in on this discussion. It's always fascinating to delve into the dynamics of the royal family and see how they navigate the complexities of their roles. I'm looking forward to bringing you more updates and insights soon. Until next time, take care and stay tuned for more fascinating royal stories. Goodbye for now, and I can't wait to share more with you in our next conversation.